theme, this is where I wanted to be going with you guys. Mm-hmm. Okay, so do the technique. Now, did you clearly walk back on your foot? Yeah. So again, I'm interested in that, because as soon as I feel you rock back before you start, so start again. Okay. Okay, you've already said to me, I want to go back. So that's what you're telling me. Okay, so I am listening to what you're telling me. And if you tell me I want to go backwards, I'm ready to throw you backwards. Okay? So, over your feet. And I'm listening to you. So you're going perfect. Okay. Now you're opening that inferior deltoid's coming in. So I want a little bit more push. A little bit more push. Up to the side. And so you've got to... Oh, as soon as you put that much weight on your front foot, you've limited yourself to only one foot in the step. Okay? So I want that, okay, push in till you feel just with your hand. And it's a very micro movement, a little bit of pressure in, straight towards you, until you feel me push back a bit. Now you've got connection to my entire body, my arms stiffen up. Slide that foot out. It's got to be a reasonable step. You know, we were doing the Urumi slide at the beginning, and bring my hand down just by or behind my heel. So you've got to figure out how you can slide enough to get to there. So that means pushing off. You're a little bit close to me. Pull down there. Now that's got it there. Okay? I want this hand coming up for the opinion. Nice. Okay? And if my head doesn't move, doesn't look away or yield, there's no opinion. Okay? So always make cool. Slide that. Don't lose control of my body. Slide that down my arm with pressure. Now drop that pressure into my elbow, and as I start to fall, step with it. So, start on your feet. Get into this upright position where you're feeling through your entire body into your floor. Because you enter the floor and up, and you're looking for these little micro movements that it tells. It tells me. Okay. So, just advance that slightly, nothing more, and you'll feel I'll resist it slightly and now you're ready to move because it will take my body with it. Okay, so lift back, lift the front foot and slide it and push. Now see the hand that moved with the body. Okay, so energy into the hand, keep putting the energy out, and your hand is now not allowed to move separately from your body. So when I put Kodageshi on, okay, now I've seen you move, so I know that you've yielded, so I can keep going through with Kodageshi. Did you at any time feel the pressure of Kodageshi drop? Because what I don't want to be doing is get to here, you've yielded, so now I'm in a safe place to move, and now I've let Kodageshi drop, because my attention is like, oh, I can step through now. So at this stage, you should be doing the counter. If you're listening to me, what I'm actually saying to you is, I'm not doing Kodageshi anymore at that point. Okay? So you should be stepping around, straightening that out, because you're listening to me. And this is actually what I'm saying when I'm doing this technique. Okay, I want to do Kodageshi. There's an instant there where I've just said, no, I've stopped doing Kodageshi, isn't it? So we'll swap around just a minute. So the feeling is, that one. Okay, so in your feet, a bit of pressure. Okay, I feel my hand didn't change. Whole structure stayed exactly the same. Okay, if I get to here, a little bit of pressure, you feel my hand suddenly said, I'm not going to do it. Soon Natasha will do it. Okay, so you might as well use that and decide what you want to do. Because I've stopped telling you what I want to do. Okay, so being a good student, okay, good young lad, you're listening to me. This is saying I want to do Soon Natasha, isn't it? No time for doing it. Of me telling you I want to do sumitoshi, change, good. So, feel that, and you've already tightened, and got the movement here, and it becomes very easy to take you down after that. Okay, but, sumitoshi part is easy. Okay, no, I want you still here, please. I'm giving you a part, which is hard. My part is the harder part, so you wait some back foot. So start with this. Okay, so there's like I'm reaching and then following the reach. So there's no change between I want to reach. Okay, now I've got full reach and now I'll step. It's It's not like that. There's a little bit of connection, and then you move with your entire body and keep stretching at the same time. So the coordination for these movements is very high. So just stretch out a little. Not your body. Okay. So you're moving your body without any change in the energy in your arm. So I want to feel that extension in your arm. Now that it's a little bit in there, you can put a bit more in if you want. Now follow with your body. Don't let this go. If you need to put more energy into that to maintain the structure, you do, and you're going to stretch forward and down just by my heel. But push off your back foot, push that forward, and if it's not going forward, then your body starts to move. So this is the internal awareness of every part of your body. And it's years and years of just feeling. So yes, start to push off your front foot, push. So push with your back, slide your front. Cool. Okay, that needs to push down more. So that should have been extending more. And that would have got me in the right position. Straight into the face. Okay. Now, keep the energy in that hand as this slides down. Okay. And the sad thing is that if you give me lots of energy through that, okay, step in and push that. And that's actually good. Notice his other hand is moving too. So as soon as that other hand drops, so people think, okay, the energy's here, so push in with that one and let that one drop. Because he's just told me, well, he wants to hold my energy, my elbow there, but he said he doesn't want my hand to be there anymore, so it's fine, I'm happy to wrap my arm around. So, all I'm doing is standing here and listening to him. Okay, so you're on back foot. And, I mean, I'm trying to get this out of myself before I'm worrying about getting it, but it's information that you can now be working on, is that if I'm regarding myself as open-centered information gathering. Okay, I've got no particular idea in mind. I could just do that if I wanted to, or whatever. But for the moment, it's far more useful for me not to be blocking your technique, not to be thinking about what you're doing, but to understand exactly what forces are going through my body in this moment. Okay, so where you go? So that's going where I want it. Now that should be increasing power as you start to slide through, and you've got to drop it more, because at the moment it's going straight through. Now if I feel energy going straight through, all you're telling me is you want me to step back, which is fine. I don't mind stepping back. Okay, because I'll stay on balance if I do. So there's a little bit of connection, then you've got to tell me you want me compressing into a little spot just behind my heel. Because if you don't tell me that, I'm still on the noxious old solid. I'm not going to do what you don't tell me to do. Okay. You just compress me into there. And move your whole body. Also, you're taking the feeling thing a little bit too seriously, because ultimately, you will feel it eventually. Okay? But you know what the technique is. So do the technique. Slide out and hit me in the face. You've done that sort of thing 1,000 times. Whether it's you know how to do that. So live in the house you already know. Okay, slide out and hit me. Just slide out and hit me. Okay, cool, perfect. Okay, but all I'm telling you is you need to look at every aspect of that a little bit more. And this is what the Key Society taught me, was to live in my own body. And so I have a very good feel of what's happening here. But also I can tell from the differences in pressure between that finger and that finger, that his arm is rotated, and I can actually just rotate his arm. I don't know, and it's not conscious, that's the point. It's just living in my body. Okay, that way? So do it, as you would normally do it in your own style, because that's your home place, and don't try and do what I do, but listen to what I'm doing to modify and improve what you do. So just do it, slide out and hit me in the head with that. Perfect, okay? So keep the pressure on that one, or extend, yes, slide down, and as that slides down, it's pushing more, and you can feel it broken. It's a really hard thing to, what's the point, I'm not sure even what I want to say, to add more, because as soon as he gets caught up in my world, and forgets his world, okay, it's wrong. If that makes sense. He's got to figure out how to do it from his world and add this feeling of life through its body that tells him so much information about not just what he's doing, but if he's feeling properly, my gripper, he'll know all about what's happening to me. I can feel it through my connection. I know a lot about how he's holding tension.